Okay, this is our parts all laid out for the Bitsy Bot, the things that you'll need to make one. Now, you can make yours out of a broad variety of things, and we highly recommend that you do that. The only thing that you really have to have is the Arduino. Everything else you can switch out for other things. You can use different types of batteries, you can use different motors, etc. I'm going to go through what I've got here and where the products came from, or where the parts came from, I should say, and then we're going to start to put a Bitsy together on this board so you can see how it's all wired up. But if you don't happen to have two hair dryers that you can take apart, you can either go and buy two electric motors and get some wheels for them, or there's a variety of things you can do to solve that problem. So again, these are two motors from our hair dryer. You can see the hair dryer blower fan there, and underneath that is a sheet of Lexan. It's just it's a stiff plastic that's really resilient, and that sheet of Lexan, it's easy to machine. You can drill holes in it and do stuff like that. So it's going to be used for mounting some of our devices. And you can get that at a hardware store for a few dollars. And this is a universal remote. And it can be gotten at Target for around $8. And we're going to use that to control our Bitsy Bot. And then we've got some electrical tape and different 22 gauge wire, and then we have some solder here. We'll use that to make our solder connections, just like if you saw the video for the motor controller, it was used to solder that together. And this is a motor controller, which will allow us to control the speed and direction of our motors. And this is our Arduino. It's our microprocessor that we can plug into, I should say a microcontroller that we can plug into our computer and download code to it to get the motor controller and other things to function the way we want them to. So this is a breadboard, and it's used for prototyping, and we're going to show you how to wire it up and how to connect different electronic components to that. And this is our digital recording module, and it's for basically recording sounds and playing them back, and we're going to use the Arduino to trigger that so that when the little bot drives around, it can make some sounds. Of course, these are just AA batteries, and they're going to go in this battery holder. The AA's are 1.5 volts, but when we connect them in series together, they're going to be 12 volts, so that'll be great for powering our motors because they want to run on a higher voltage than 1.5. And so we have our different transistors here that we're going to use to make to do some switching in our circuits. And we've got some three-color LED and some screws and nuts, and then a bunch of resistors, and these are 330 ohm, 10k ohm, 220 ohm. We'll go into the details on that kind of stuff later. And then I have some of the board of our alarm clock radio, so we're going to use some components off of that board. And we've got our coffee maker here, or I should say our coffee carafe. It's just the holder for the coffee, and we're going to use some of the components on this for the Bitsy. And then we have some over here. You can see some zip ties, and so we also have we're going to need a infrared sensor for the Bitsy, and that infrared sensor will be used for sensing from the remote control, and so it looks like this, and we'll have one of those as well.